is the back panel. This is the front panel. The front panel is much wider. You see here, the width of the back panel is up here, and the front panel is there. Back panel, I made it the same amount of rows as the front panel, only I did not crochet the last row, because we're going to crochet them together. Please keep in mind that I started with double crochets, but I actually ripped it out and I made half double crochets in the back loops. The ribbing is exactly the same. What you will do, the last row is the good side row, so you end it off at the good side, the correct side, and I'm facing here the wrong side of the last row. So what we will do is as follow. We have to attach this piece here up there, and exactly the same as the other shoulder piece. So you put the last row from the wrong side row, the correct side row facing you, and then you pick up your work and you start off with the last row crocheting. Only we start to attach those two pieces together. So this last row is actually the correct side of your work. I already made my chain one, so we'll turn my work around. First you will measure up the width of the shoulder seams you would like to have. So you can take, for example, the same amount of stitches that you need for a regular sweater, because the front is much bigger than the back, so you will get this waterfall here. I decided I do about 14 stitches together on each side. So we start off with this side here. I will zoom the camera in to show you how to do it. First of all, I make my chain one and I start off directly with a half double crochet in the back loop, in the two loops. So instead of the double crochet, I changed it up into half double crochets. So what I will do now is I will pull up this loop and pick my first stitch here, this one. I put my hook from the front to the back underneath both loops, because this is the first stitch here, underneath both loops from the front to the back. I pick that loop up again, tie it a bit up, and pull that loop through that stitch like this. That's all. Yarn around and then you go to the next stitch. Please keep in mind we still crochet in the back loops only. So this is number one. Here's my back loop and I make my half double crochet in it. This is number two. Pull up the loop and then you go back to the front panel and you pick up the next stitch underneath one loop. So here, this one. Put your yarn around your hook and pull through. Go to the next stitch. Put your hook through the back and make your half double crochet, pull up the loop, find your next stitch here in the back loop, put your yarn back on your hook and pull that loop through. Well, this to be repeated up until the width you have measured for your shoulder seam. In my case, I will have 14 half double crochets in a row. That is enough for me for my shoulder seam. I just finished my 14 half double crochets through the back loop and attaching them together with the front panel. Now we go crochet the stitches at the back panel as normal, as you have done throughout the complete pieces, and then count from the other side your 14 stitches back. Stop there in the 15th stitch from the edge, and then we start sewing these two shoulder seams together. So for now, half double crochets in the back posts and the back loops from your back panel up until you are on the 15th stitch from the other edge counted on. And then we start sewing the other piece together by using half double crochets in the back loop only. Well, I've done my stitches and I am here at my 15th stitch from this side on, and I've got 14 stitches left to do. Now I'll count from the front panel as well, 14 stitches back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Here's my stitch. What I will do, first I will half double crochet in the, in the back panel first, and then I'll go to the stitch on the front panel, and I will be repeating like I've done in the beginning. Pull the loop through, then go back to the back panel, make your half double crochet in the back loop only, pull up the loop and go to the second stitch, so the next stitch in the back loop, and pull your loop through. This way you are sewing two pieces together by using the same stitch you have done throughout this whole sweater. So, not that hard. Take your time with it. Make sure that your loops have an even tension. That is important. That way you get a nice and beautiful effect at the end. Hereby, just to show you how it will look as the front panel, as the back panel. You see, this is all bigger than the front panel. So that way you get a little fluffy effect of this sweater. Is really gorgeous, and the yarn makes the difference as well. So it really depends on which yarn you're using to create which style you like. Here is the side. You remember that I made a chain one before I start off with chain three for the foundation double crochet row, and I put that loop tight. Now, well, here's why. When I put a hook in, it won't go anywhere. So that's why I always tie that first chain I made. Well, here's my new yarn, and here's my yarn at the bottom of this sweater. What I will do is as follow. I put old yarn over my new yarn and wrap it around it like this, back to the front. Go and tie it up till that little piece is at your beginning. Then take that same yarn, this yarn, over the new yarn, like this. And then from the front to the back, through that loop, so around it, like this. Pull up. Now you've got a little 8 shape. Tie it, and it won't go anywhere. It is stuck for life. If you want to take it out, you need a scissor. So, now, take my hook, pull through. Pick up that loop first, like this. I put those little two tails over my work and I chain one. Now it's 100% more secure, just to be in case. Yarn around and go to the same stitch, and there you make your half double crochet in it, like this. That's the first stitch. Pull a bit through so that that stitch has been hidden. Now you find every row a little nice spot to put your hook through. Make sure that you go underneath two loops. So here is one loop, don't go in there. Pick this one here. Here you get two loops. Here. There. Put my yarn over those little two tails and pull through and make your half double crochet. Got my second one. That's for this row. Every row you see, you make one half double crochet in it. Here's my next row. So you skip that one loop, you go to the next row, and you find a nice little spot to put your hook through. Sometimes it's not that easy to do, but please do take your time. Well, if it's not working here, you go in this V-shaped stitch. You make there your next half double crochet. If you turn around, here's the next one. Here, so there you put your hook through. One. Here's my next V-shaped stitch. Half double crochet. Here's the next. Pick them up and make your next half double crochet in it. So that way you get everywhere an even number of even number of stitching. You don't need to count anymore. If you do it like this, Here it is. Then you don't need to count. So, repeat this up until you're at the shoulder seam. And then we start off with counting the stitches which you were needing for the armholes. And then we start off with crocheting them together again. Well, I just arrived at the shoulder seam. As you can see, I put one in that particular spot here. And then I go count the stitches that I need for my shoulder, for my armholes. So, for example, I need 10 or 12 stitches. So, you go make your 10 or 12 stitches. For me, I already know where to start, so where to stop. So for you, count your 10 stitches or 12 or 14 or 20 stitches, which amount you need. So put it around your body and take some stitch markers and place the stitch marker at the point that is underneath the armpit, in the armpit, so underneath your armholes. Put your stitch marker there. Count the stitches, and then you start making those stitches on the other panel as well. So, for example, I would say I'll have to make a sleeve ending here. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 stitches. So 14, because this one is in the seam. 14 stitches. Let's get started. Here's my next stitch, 14. This is number 1. Number 2. You see, I directly put my tail, which I cut aside my work, so I don't need to hide it in later. Number 2, 3. So, for now. 14 stitches from the shoulder seam. I will count them first again because I did not place any stitch marker. Let's see. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Here's my stitch. So, what I will do is take my next stitch, this one, and take them together. So, I will put those together like this. So, I've made my 14 stitches here, and I counted my 14 stitches over there. You see how it's lining up? Here is the V-shaped stitch, and here's the V-shaped stitch. That way I know I am in the correct spot. So, now I will start off with making one half double crochet in the next stitch first. Pull up the loop. Then I'll go to the spot which I've noticed where I should start, here. Go underneath both loops this time. Put your hook through and pull that loop through. Now that stitch is stuck. Go to the next stitch, here. Make your half double crochet in it. Pull up the loop, sorry. Go to your next stitch, here. And go from the front to the back, underneath both loops. Grab your loop, put it through that spot. So go to the next spot here, make your half double crochet in it, pull up the loop, go to the back part here. Here's my stitch. Go through both loops, underneath both loops here. Two loops. Put the loop back on your hook and pull that loop through. And go on up until you're back at the bottom. And then this row is done. And then you will do the same at the other side. So you count your stitches and then half double crochet them together. That's all there is. Well, if you want to have a sleeveless sweater, then you're ready to go after this row. You're done. You'll be ready to wear it. If you really want to have sleeves into it, I will show you how to do that. It's actually really easy. So, I'm really curious about what you made of it, and which yarn you used, which hook size. Please let me know. Give your reaction here on this YouTube channel. I'd love to hear from you. So I'll finish this off, and then we start off with the sleeves.